What's going on, Rushers? Welcome back to Stage Rush TV, and this week I am joined by the ladies of the Craptacular. I'm joined by Lucky and the Mick. Thank you so much for coming on Stage Rush TV.
Thank you for having us. We're very excited to be here.
The Craptacular, if you have not seen it yet, which I'm sure you have to go check it out. It is one of the most funny blogs about Broadway, where you guys do interviews with people like Tom Riley from Arcadia, which is always really exciting because you put your own flair into it. It's hilarious. You must go check it out. For great interviews and Broadway musings, you have to check it out. So ladies, this has been an interesting week on Broadway now that it's post-Tonys, now there's kind of just like other eccentric little offbeat things going on. And I went to, today was the kickoff of Broadway and Bryant Park. And I went to that first concert. And I'm so excited that it's kicked off because I really love it. It's one of my favorite Broadway summer events. Yeah. However, I will say that it started off on a low note. It's almost like I feel like it's starting off low so that these weeks are just gonna grow in intensity and be more exciting. It was kind of a weird lineup today. It started out with Zarkana, which, I mean, how much can the Cirque du Soleil people really do? Are they gonna do like the trapeze thing on the Broadway stage? No, they're not.
So not the first thing you think of. All they didn't bring Broadway like the ringing out.
They didn't bring that. All they did was send their like clown actors into the audience to just like do little whoop whoop things with the people.
Did they touch you?
They didn't touch me, no.
That's tickets.
So then Baby It's You came on, and you know, I think we all know what I think about that show. But I think it was actually pretty good because they weren't dressed in their silly, ridiculous-looking costumes. Christina Saju actually looked pretty hot with her short, like Rihanna-style haircut, and it was really good. It was like a concert. It's clearly better as a concert than as a play.
That's probably how they should do the actual show.
They definitely should. And then there was Sister Act, which was really good. The singers were great, but there was no Patina Miller.
Which is sort of like, what's the point? What's the point?
Isn't that
which
strange?
Number did they do?
Take Me to Heaven, of course, they ended with that.
Take me to heaven, take me to paradise.
Why wouldn't she come? She is really buzzed about now, but she's not a huge star yet. She's beginning. I think she should have been there. Unless the producers have her on vocal rest.
Yeah, unless she's not speaking.
She may not
right.
Well,
but you guys also saw something really cool this week.
We did.
Yeah, we actually saw the return of Hair, the much-touted Summer of Love at the St. James.
You were there for the first performance,
yes,
right?
Yes, we saw the first performance.
Tuesday,
and there was a pretty crazy turnout. There were very long lines.
The line was like to the disco. I mean, it was most of the way to Times Square from the St. James, which I never even saw for Idiot. Like, it was. There were a lot of freaking people. Yeah. Were there friends?
What was the atmosphere like? Was it a packed house?
It wasn't full.
It wasn't packed, but it's the St. James. That place is an airplane hangar.
It's a barn.
You could fit a bazillion people in there.
They were
well sold, though. For the St. James,
I would say that
had to be 70.
Were there like multiple standing ovations mid-show? Did they stop the show?
There was not quite as much as like if you saw the final original revival cast before they went to London.
That
show
was a
like
lot
couldn't
of
go
ovation.
On. There were so many, but there was a lot of applause. They did kind of slow the show down in a couple places. Certainly, the opening applause was huge. Yeah. They just stood there like could not start the show because people would stop clapping. Lucky was like not too excited about going to see it. She was kind of coming because obviously. Anyone has ever been to our website, you know that I have an enormous crush on Steele Burkhart. Like, ridiculous.
Who is Steele Burkhart?
Stop it!
He was in the original Broadway cast. He was in the Park cast. He was in the concert staging. He's been on the show forever. That's
what
the only
else
way
has
I know
he done on?
He
I just
that's
I'm
it.
Not, I'm not.
He literally graduated college and went straight into this show. Went into the concert staging. Went into the Park staging. Went into Broadway.
He's been in
Maryland. I can't believe he's that young. I had to Google this guy just to see what he looks like because the Mick talks about him so much. I was like,
every
I don't even know what he looks. He looks like the brawny man. How is it? No, I mean, he looks like the brawny man. How is he 24, 25?
Like,
I don't.
He's like, no, he's probably
or less, actually.
I don't know how old he is for sure, but he's in that, like, age group. But
he looks like 33,
and
the brawny man. Like, he's been on some paper towels.
I can't talk about it. He is the most beautiful person ever. When he walked out on that stage, I almost died.
Really excited.
Like, I had to
really
be, like,
excited.
I can't, like, he ran past me in his little loincloth, and I swear to God, I'm trying not to say the word boner a million times right now, but that is how I feel.
So this is like a big exciting show that's coming right now, and there's not a whole lot to look forward to now in the summer, but there's tons of stuff. This is when all the announcements are being made for the fall.
Yeah.
And every time like something, a headline comes across Twitter, I get so excited about what's coming. So I thought it would be fun to go through what will be playing on the Broadway marquees in the fall, and actually there's some that we know of that go into the spring. So we're gonna go through them. Bonnie and Clyde comes in November. It's gonna starring Laura Osnes and Jeremy Jordan. It's playing at the Schoenfeld Theater. This is a Frank Wildhorn musical. And after
there's been so much success with those on
after
Broadway,
the Wonderland debacle. But what I'm hearing is that this actually might be his, like, a redemption, because I'm hearing the buzz, this anonymous buzz, I guess from readings. There have been readings and people have been talking.
Yeah,
that this actually is a pretty good show. So
but is,
maybe
there's like two Bonnie and Clyde musicals. Is the buzz getting crossed?
That's a good question.
Because there was another one with, like, Swenson and Sutton, I think, did a reading.
Ooh.
And that's that cannot be the same one. So.
But also, too, I think that said, like, you know, if Jekyll and Hyde was, like, did, like, a one-night revival tomorrow, I would instantly go see it.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, like,
but is this
could be kind of awesome.
This might be, this isn't going to be, like, a glittery fantasy Bonnie and Clyde. Like, I'm hoping it's kind of gritty.
That you don't know.
You know what I think is interesting?
But, like,
that it's
but does Wildhorn do gritty?
Maybe, I don't know.
The Civil War.
Oh, yeah, that was so gritty.
Follies, which I'm really excited about, because for those of us that just weren't going to get out to D.C., I'm really excited to see that it's coming here. Okay, you're not feeling the
totally
same way.
Not
clearly, clearly the Mick is not
I'm
feeling
sorry.
The same way.
I'm sorry.
You're not excited. Wait, you're not excited about Bernadette Peters and Jan Maxwell and a classic Stephen
it's
Sondheim
musical
coming.
It's about fucking old people. Miserable, unhappy,
who says there are
no
roles for old actresses now? Meryl Streep,
that's
you
not,
can't
and it's
say.
Not, and Bernadette Peters isn't even really old. So, like, I can't, like, it just,
well,
it's just not my, it's, I'm just not the target demographic.
Well, have you seen Follies then before?
No.
Oh, because that's the thing. I haven't seen it. So I'm excited to have the chance to see it now.
I guess. I mean, I
it's
do
also,
love
it's just
Stephen
a chance
Sondheim.
To see another Stephen Sondheim.
I do love
Yeah,
Stephen
I mean,
Sondheim.
That's the thing. I think that every season we sort of look for reasons to revive a new Sondheim. And I think if we were like, it's going to be a revival of Sondheim with really wonderful, incredibly seasoned, talented actresses, I think we did that, like, last season.
Well, but
so
it's a different show.
I know.
Well, there's also Porgy and Bess coming with Audra McDonald and Norm Lewis. Mr. Abs, are those abs real?
Yes. Oh my God.
Yes, they
I don't
are.
Get that.
Oh.
I don't get that. That was those King Triton abs were kind of scary. And David Alan Grier, which will be interesting because now he's in the musical.
And Josh Henry.
Yeah, and Josh Henry.
Really?
Too.
Yes.
Awesome. I am now even more looking forward to this.
Yeah.
And directed by Diane Paulus.
Yeah.
Who went up here.
That's something that, yeah, they're doing it out of town in Boston first, so I think there will be a lot of road trips up north.
I'm not sure if
we'll
I love this musical, but I think it's going to be a great cast. Great.
Well, they're trying to turn it into more of a book musical than
like
it was in the past. They're reinterpreting it. They brought in
Susan Laurie
Park to do the book.
It.
And they're really trying to make this more of a book musical than an opera, which it was written as an opera. So I'm really excited to see what happens. And I mean, Audra McDonald could, like, sing the fucking phone book. She is resplendent. So
this will be exciting because I admittedly this is my first opportunity now to see her on stage or something.
Oh really?
I just meant, you know, I wasn't around for 110 in the Shade, you know, so this is yet another opportunity. Like, I'm glad I can check one off my classic Broadway performer list. I'll have gotten that. So
I'm really excited for this one. I'm really excited.
Godspell coming in October. I could care less about this show.
Really?
If Gavin
Couldn't
Crewe was casting
less.
It, I would.
If it has an awesome cast,
more.
It's going to be awesome. I mean,
obviously.
Isn't that like the rule for everything, though?
Well, I mean, I don't.
I don't like the music to this show. I know it's Stephen Schwartz.
Don't?
I don't like the music. I think
really?
They,
God
however.
The
oh my
think
God,
they,
did you hear the reinterpreted
back
God
Man?
Save the People that they're doing
clearly
for this, too?
Well, that they were possibly
they
doing
They were possibly
for this.
Doing this reinterpreted.
Back when it was happening last time, not this time.
You know what I am excited? I think this good about this show, in production-wise, they've got the best theater possible.
Yes.
Circle and the Square.
They have the perfect
That's going to work so well for that show.
I mean, I think that's part of what they held. They held it longer, probably.
Well, they were probably like, their mouth watering when Lombardi goes. They're like, oh, yes, I have to get it.
Give us that theater right now.
I think they were like, we're on it. Now, this is the show that I am most excited about.
Say.
What am I going to say? What
on
show
a
is
clear
it?
Day.
I am most excited about On a Clear
Me too,
Day.
Me too, of all of them.
I was lucky enough to be at the Vassar Powerhouse reading last summer.
Well, I smell you.
It was incredible. It was so good, and I actually got it when Anika Noni Rose was in it before she had to leave for...
Wow.
Oh, it was...
Before
anyway.
She became too famous for all of this.
Well, I know. I wish she would do it. You know, Michael Riedel, though, had a really good suggestion for her part, though. Montego Glover come over from Memphis.
Rebecca Jones, I thought.
Rebecca Naomi Jones.
Wow, that
Rebecca
would be great.
Jones.
Oh, and she's got the Michael Mayer connection, so that might happen.
We've had this conversation before.
That would be
we just cast this
Oh, that's great.
Show.
It's fine. I'm on board. I'm
no,
totally on board
Montego
with
Glover, I would way rather see.
Harry Connick Naomi Jr., Jones. Michael Mayer directing.
The perfect man. The perfect man.
This was... He's kind of the perfect man.
Is,
I can see that.
He is the perfect man. He can sing. He can play piano. He's funny.
He's a band leader.
Ridiculously handsome.
Yeah.
probably this has the same body.
This show reworked. Mm-hmm. I mean, I of course didn't see the original, but it's just off. It's reworked. It's so great. It's really unique. It's so intriguing. The thing that I'm worried about though, it's so good. It's playing the St. James, which is a huge house.
Yeah,
and
it
I'm
does
worried.
Kind of
but it's Harry. Do we think Harry can like?
That's the formula, right? That you need an A-list star now to fill a big house.
Well, but
I'm
I don't
still
know.
Worried.
If it's Harry like, and it's good.
Yeah, I mean, if it gets good reviews,
I think
right?
it's going to get good
Harry.
Reviews. It's got an A-list. So I think it could. It has that. I mean, I'm not damning it, but I think.
The St. James is
just
worried. The St. James is scary.
It's
it
a really big theater,
a bit,
and yeah. it has had some hard times recently with shows. So then we've got in November, Private Lives with Kim Cattrall, which in my opinion on that is
whatever, whatevs.
Kind of, except that I like really care. Like her. So
I think, a lot. Of, I mean,
like her.
I mean,
she's great, but I
mean,
I don't think I need to see that show, but I probably will anyway.
I think that's really snoozy.
Yeah.
Then we've got Stickfly in November, which is such
I'm
a
sorry,
strange
the who?
It's what? Called Stickfly. Oh. And it's I mean, kinda, it sounds like
kind of like
it sounds like a Tyler Perry premise, but it's produced by Alicia Keys, which now that's cool that she's producing it. I would rather she star in it.
Fair enough.
Alicia.
But I don't think she is.
Can we make that happen?
Now, here's
you have
the
a
thing.
Child, this would give you like a steady job where you stay home.
It's playing.
Broadway is the beautiful grind.
Oh, I know, right? It's playing the Lyceum. Dun, dun, dun!
That theater is cursed.
So it's not gonna do well, I think it's fair to say.
I don't know how far we can go with the notion of the cursed Broadway theater.
The Lyceum
literally. I think we can. Marquee maybe yeah. not. I was pushing for that, but I think the Lyceum
okay.
I can
the Lyceum
say
fair enough. Has done some, fair enough. Some bad things to some shows.
And then I think the final coming in October, I'm just really excited about, and I think we're all for just one reason only, Venus and Fur.
Nina
with Nina
Arianda.
And I think they just brought that back because they were just like, wait, sure.
They were
stupid.
Like, let's give this girl something to do. I know.
Which I think is awesome. I mean, and...
No, I think it's... the thing about it that's so fascinating, right? I mean, they clearly brought this back because she was the far and away standout of Born Yesterday. And I think they realized, like, there is an audience for... That's amazing. This woman... They were like,
we need to get her back
Broadway
on Broadway.
Show. Like, so great. I'm like, we need to get her back on Broadway. What the hell are we gonna do? Oh, that play with like, that's amazing.
That other thing that she did. Let's
that
make
they're
that
bringing
happen.
This back for her is like,
we love her.
Wow.
She's so awesome.
Moving on to some of the Broadway grosses. Baby It's You sold 78% of its tickets, which means it's climbing up back up the ladder. Which pff,
how is that even scientifically possible in reality?
Sort of finding its legs. Did it ever have, I don't
does
know.
Does it have legs?
Does it
stupid
have legs?
Tourists. It's summertime. That's what it is. Stupid tourists. It's
not
summertime.
All tourists are stupid.
The stupid ones are going to see that one.
I guess so. And then Bengal Tiger closed at 63% this week, which is what a sad little number.
I
thought was totally great and had Robin Williams in it.
I never would have thought in my wildest Broadway dreams that there would be a Robin Williams play, the play Broadway, that would tank like this one.
I know. That like... did not really do well
and
at all.
It was really good.
And it was great.
And
I
had
know.
Other good people in it
it's
other
a
than
fucking
Robin.
Pulitzer Prize in the running for the Pulitzer. Like, and Robin Williams and...
Always a bridesmaid this show. Always a bridesmaid. But, yeah, that's a sad one.
Oh, so we're up to Sister Act, which was at 69%, which...
I'm surprised at that.
That's low, and I'm shocked, because when we were trying to see it in previews a couple times, they were... packed house.
Not a ticket
previews,
anywhere.
Not a ticket to buy. We couldn't, at the box office, they were like, nope, sorry, we have nothing. How is it at
they just didn't want you to see the show.
Right
clearly, they were like holding their tickets behind their back.
They
were
like,
we don't want you to see
we know who that bitch is.
Completely sold out. Sorry.
So, and next week, if the grosses don't go up, I'm blaming it on you, Patina Miller, because you did not go to Broadway and Bryant Park.
Stop it.
Be nice to her.
Patina.
She's beautiful and talented.
She is beautiful. I wanted to see her in Broadway and Bryant Park. And Adam's Family all of a sudden shot right back up to 91% after being so low. And I had to look up why. Why is it? It's because this was... Brooke Shields' first week in the show as Morticia. Really? Brooke Shields really got that show up tonight? Really? People are really clamoring to see her in that show?
Maybe,
I'm shocked.
Maybe her, like, epic meltdown at the Tonys was like, goodbye.
Oh,
it was,
that
like,
was so
comeback-y.
Awkward. That's what I thought
excuse
about
me, sorry,
her performance
excuse me.
And about her appearance at the Tonys. Well, what does not make me sad is having you guys here on Stage Rash TV.
Thank you.
Lucky and the Mick from the Craptacular. If you want to go laugh about Broadway instead of cry about it, go to the Craptacular site and you will not be disappointed. Thank you so much for joining us
this
week.
Thank you for having us. This was great.
Have a great week at the theater.
Thank you.